since I was impressed by Tamanna Bhatia's performance very much, and she has appreciated all the artist's performance. So say some good things about Tamanna's performance.
Actually, the thing is, when I finished the script of the movie, I want an artist. That's the core of the movie, actually. She should be very powerful in her performance. At the same time, audience should relate to her. And she should have a star value also. So, we have to put together everything. The glamour should be there, that everybody knows that Tamanna is glamorous. Everything. But performance-oriented, I want to bring the other side of Tamanna. Because I know, already we have worked in a movie, I know how talented she was. The movie before that, we worked on some movie called Action. The title itself was Action, and we did some miraculous, great action sequence in Turkey, Azerbaijan, everywhere, and she did a fabulous job. Now I want to bring out that emotional and performance side of Tamanna. I think once you watch the movie, you'll understand, you can see it by yourself, how talented she is, because the other side of Tamanna, which before that I think nobody have seen, a lot of movies, it came out in Aramanai 4. And such a fantastic actor, such a dedicated, because a heroine to nearly survive for nearly 18 years, it's not an easy job. Only the dedication, professionalism, everything will make her what she is now, made her what she is now. And Aramanai 4, I am very happy, because in the South, nobody expected Tamanna to perform so well, to be frank. And it was a sweet surprise for everybody. And whoever comes out of theater after watching the movie, the first thing is they talk about is Tamanna's performance. So thanks Tamanna for getting it great, and I tortured her so much. It was, even though she's doing some emotional scenes, it was totally in the rope, lot of action sequences. She's carrying two kids in the rope, have to fly, dive, lot of things. Even after the death in the movie, she was having the rope scenes, everything. So difficult to perform very that. That difficult sequence, Tamanna came out with flying colors, and thanks her for making my praise to Tamanna to come out. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Sir, please हर press meet पे आइएगा. मैं आपका मतलब मैं contact number आपका ले लेती हूँ.
ठीक. And Khushbu ji, आपको देखकर बड़ी खुशी हुई. Sunil Dutt साहब के साथ आपकी फिल्म देखी थी हमने आप. बहुत मासूम चेहरा था उस time भी और आज भी आप वैसी लगती.
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया.
कुछ कहिए.
जैसे मैंने कहा कि बहुत अच्छा लगता है, मेरी शुरुआत यहीं से हुई है, पैदाइश परवरिश पूरी मुंबई से हुई है, सो मुंबई ची मुलगी मी, बट अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट काम था तो चेन्नई गई, वहाँ पे बस मिल गए, वहीं पर अटक गई, तो एंड बस कहते हैं ना कि कुछ डिसीजंस ऐसे होते हैं कि वो एक भगवान की कृपा होती है, उनकी देन होती है, तो मैं ट्रूली समझती हूँ कि मेरी ज़िंदगी में मेरे बेटर हाफ सुंदर सर जो हैं वो एक भगवान की देन है, क्योंकि अगर वो ना होते तो शायद मैं यहाँ नहीं होती, क्योंकि कहते हैं कि कहा जाता है बिहाइंड एवरी सक्सेसफुल मैन देयर इज अ वुमन, बट आई ट्रूली बिलीव बिहाइंड एवरी सक्सेसफुल वुमन देयर इज अ मैन हु हैज़ अ बिगर हार्ट, एंड दैट इज डेफिनेटली माई हस्बैंड. तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है कि आज तक मैंने नहीं देखा जिंदगी में उन्होंने मुझसे कहा होगा तो एक चीज़ ना करें. कहते हैं उनकी ओपिनियन होते हैं, लेकिन कहते हैं कि डिसीजन तुम्हारा होना चाहिए. एंड जहाँ तक फिल्म का सवाल है, हर वक्त जब मैं बॉम्बे आती हूँ कोई ना कोई पूछता है कि आप हिंदी में क्यों नहीं काम करती हैं, आप इतने साल हिंदी में से क्यों दूर रही हैं. वहाँ पर काम था, फिर शादी, फिर इमीडिएट दो बच्चे, और मैं बहुत ही हैंड्स ऑन मदर रही हूँ. तो दो बेटियों को बड़ा करते करते काफ़ी वक्त लगा. बड़ी बेटी ये सितंबर में 24 साल की हो जाएगी और छोटी वाली 21 साल की है. तो बस फैमिली लाइफ में रही, अभी वक्त है, तो अभी शुरुआत होने वाली है तो देखते हैं. बट बहुत अच्छा लगता है यहाँ पर एज अ प्रोड्यूसर आप सबके सामने यहाँ पर खड़ी हूँ, तो उसमें बहुत ही एक फख्र महसूस होता है. अच्छा लगता है कि यहाँ से दूर रही लेकिन फिर भी एक कुछ अचीव करके, जिंदगी में कुछ हासिल करके, एक मुकाम पर पहुंच कर आप सबके सामने आई हूं, तो बहुत ही अच्छा लगता है. थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग हियर.
हाय, माय क्वेश्चन इज टू ऑल द वुमेन हियर. Hi, I'm from CNN News 18. I think this was a great week for all of us. You know, our women shone really bright at the Cannes. Now, you know, your film, which is largely about women, there's, you know, one woman helming it, two women headlining it, you know, earning 100 crores, which is a great feat in itself. What do you have to say about this? You know, what does this two achievements mean for women in cinema, in terms of money, in terms of everything?
It means that women have arrived. It's high time people stop looking at women. I mean, I definitely do not appreciate when they say, every time a woman achieves, oh, she is shattering the glass ceiling. I said, why these terms are used only for women? It's because they do not expect women to do well. There's a basic mindset where they feel that women cannot do, there's something which holds them back. But I say you give them a platform to achieve, give them those wings to fly high, and women can do wonders. So what we have seen at Cannes and what we see with Aran Manekpo, with of course Tamanna and Rashi, and we have a very brilliant actor called Kove Sarla, she's a character actor who has done a very major role in the film. I think these three women have really taken it forward, and I think all I say is stop looking at women with a very pre-assumed mindset that women cannot achieve. Just let them loose, give them that free hand. Like, you never ask a man, he has achieved something, he's broken, you know, broken the glass ceiling. Nay. So why those kind of phrases is only for women. Appreciate women. The equality has to start in your minds the minute you understand that women are absolutely equal to men, not physically, but when it comes to terms with their professionalism or their talents. I think women are definitely a step ahead of men when it comes to talents. So just let them fly. Just let them go free and stop judging them. You know, even before you know them, most of the people around, they come with this judgment, a very opinionated and lot of judgments about a woman. So I think we need to stop being opinionated about them. We need to stop having our judgments about them and just let them be as they are. And you will see women will be flying high.
I think it's a validation for all of us as female actors that we can hold a film on our shoulders and still deliver. For that, we also need filmmakers who believe in us, filmmakers like Sundar C. Sir and everybody who puts an effort to put such a film on a female's shoulder. And I think art and cinema should be beyond gender. It's high time we treat it like that. And I think films like Article 370 or Crew or even now our film have only proven that women are as far ahead as men are, and I think even this conversation shouldn't exist in time, where everybody should be treated equally, and everybody and art should be judged by the way it's made and not by who's in it, I feel. And that should go beyond gender, that's what I feel. And I also feel that that should also I mean, we should get better paychecks in films, honestly, because there is a huge gap, and I hope that happens in time. It's a process, but I'm very, very proud of what has happened in Cannes as well. Seeing those women, you know, it's an amazing feeling, because, you know, anybody who lights the way paves that path for all of us. And I'm very, very proud of the film, and I'm proud of what women are achieving. Indian women also, like, far wide, worldwide. So I think it's a very proud moment for us to bring this film to you and tell you that, okay, this is what we've earned, and this is what we are bringing to the Hindi audiences, and I hope that you guys watch it and the numbers go even higher up, because that really validates our existence in the industry is what I feel. Thank you.
Hi, Mayuria from Beyond Bollywood Center. Kyunki Tamanna ji ne kaha ki Mumbai media bahut फनी है या अम्यूजिंग, आई ट्राई टू, आई होप आई एम अम्यूजिंग. तो मेरा पहला सवाल तमन्ना जी से है कि एक फिल्म जिसके अंदर भूत का कुछ नाम भाग हो, तो फिर क्या ये कहना चाहिए कि भागो भाग आया या फिर चल भाग?
आप डिपेंड करता है आप कौन से सिटी से हैं. अगर आप दिल्ली से हैं तो फिर भाग ही आएगा, लेकिन अगर आप साउथ से हैं तो आपको बाकू बोलना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि एक्चुअली ये आसामीज शब्द है. सो या रियली डिपेंड्स फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर.
And Rashi, I've been dying to ask this to you for the last few years. सच सच बताना, रसोड़े में कौन था?
रसोड़े में दूसरी राशि थी, मैं नहीं थी भाई.
And Sundar sir, I mean, reading about that, I've not seen any of the films, but I've read all about them. And you're playing advocate. I think this is the second film where you're playing the advocate. So I wonder, like, usually in a horror film, you'll find a hero playing a doctor, a cop, a psychiatrist. When he plays a lawyer, I mean, there's no option of even throwing the law books at the ghost.
No, just as a character, it doesn't influence anywhere in the script. Just as a character, I have to do some job. So it's a lawyer. So nothing particular reason to play a lawyer or a doctor in this movie.
And Rachio, you briefly mentioned about horror films, how you like it. And I want to know from both Rashi and Tamanna, like growing up in Bombay and Delhi respectively, what were the kind of horror films, if you can, just talk about that experience growing up in these cities and the kind of horror that you look forward to in your younger days?
I think bachpan mein to koi horror film mein dekhna chahta nahi hai when you're growing up. But I think I started loving horror films when I was growing up as a teenager. तो मुझे उर्मिला जी की एक फिल्म थी भूत भूत ना उनका या दैट वाज वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट हिंदी हॉरर फिल्म्स एंड यूजुअली हम हॉरर फिल्म्स देखते हैं तो इंग्लिश फिल्में ही दिमाग में आती हैं जैसे कंजूरिंग है तो वो सीरीज आती हैं बट आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट मुझे नहीं पता था कि इन टाइम इन लाइफ आई विल बी अ पार्ट ऑफ अ सीरीज इन द हॉरर जॉनर सो आई एम वेरी हैप्पी एंड प्राउड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ इट बट हाँ बचपन से हिंदी में तो मुझे भूत याद है और नैना उनका नाम था शायद फिल्म में नाम का तो आई रिमेंबर दैट वेरी क्लियरली बिकॉज आई रिमेंबर दैट फिल्म शुक मी बिकॉज शी वॉज फैंटास्टिक इन द फिल्म और आई थिंक हॉरर एज अ जॉनर शुड बी एक्सप्लोर्ड मोर ऐसा मुझे लगता है बिकॉज बहुत सारी ऐसी कहानियाँ हैं जो स्पेशली हमारे इंडियन फ्रेम में बिकॉज आई फील बहुत अलग अलग जगहों से अलग अलग जैसे हमने तमिल फिल्म बनाई एक असामीज भूत के बारे में जान के तो आई एम श्योर दैट देर आर सो मेनी मोर स्टोरीज एंड आई होप ऐसी स्टोरीज बनती रहें और यू नो हमारे हम जैसी ऑडियंस एंटरटेन होती रहे
एक्चुअली मेरी फेवरेट फिल्म सेम एज राशि हिंदी में भूत रही है उर्मिला जी का काम बहुत बहुत उस वक्त सब हिल गए थे क्योंकि इस किस्म का परफॉर्मेंस तो हमने देखा नहीं था और उनसे ऐसा रोल एक्सपेक्ट नहीं किया था लेकिन जो इंग्लिश फिल्म है जो शायद मैंने इसी थिएटर में देखी थी आई डोंट नो इफ इट वाज दिस थिएटर बट इट वाज अराउंड दिस एरिया वाज हाउस ऑफ वैक्स एंड उसमें ना वो मार देता है लोगों को उनको अलग अलग तरीकों से वैक्स इस्तेमाल करके उनको मार देता है तो उसके बाद मैं वैक्सिंग नहीं कर पा रही थी क्योंकि एवरी टाइम आई वुड वांट टू गो फॉर वैक्सिंग आई वुड जस्ट थिंक ऑफ दिस मैन ट्राइंग टू किल पीपल विथ by putting backs on them and chipkawing them and then I don't know doing strange things so that was a bit traumatizing but I believe मुझे छेड़खानी करना पसंद नहीं है तो मैं तो बहुत डरती हूँ तो I'm actually the audience जो ऐसे horror films देखती है कुछ हुआ क्या so like that's me watching a horror film I kind of don't see it I hear it most of the times
hello hi
I'm are you from Reddit congratulations on the big success of the film. I have already seen the film when I was in Chennai and I had a lot of fun and I hope it creates the same magic here as well. My question is from Khushbu ma'am. We have seen your foray into politics after doing tremendous work in films. Tell me what's next on your political plan. Do you harbor a dream of becoming a CM if and when BJP enters into the state? And who is your favorite politician, who not from your own political party, that's your favorite?
Okay, I didn't expect a political question in a filmy theater, but I am part of BJP, so like everyone else, I'm waiting for the results on June 4th, which we are very sure that ab ki baar 400 paar, phir ek baar Modi sarkar. So there's no two ways about it. We're absolutely excited about that. Apart from my party leader, apart from the highest regards what I have for a prime minister, if you ask me who has been my favorite politician, I would always say it was Dr. Kalinger because I started with my political life with Dr. Kalinger's party when he was the chief minister and I think I always consider him to be my teacher when it comes to the political nuances. I've learned a lot from him. So I have greatest regards and I always hold him in high esteem. So it has to be, apart from my leader, it has to be Dr. Kalinger.
Tamanna, your
center. This question is for Mr. Sundar C. Yeah. Hi, and then I would love Tamanna and Rashi, of course, to join in the question. Very interesting, some time back you mentioned that one of the main reasons why you chose to cast yourself in the film is that you were pretty sure that any other hero, any other, you know, big hero, action hero would have added more kind of value to the film and, you know, helped in the promotion. It always helps, right? You were pretty sure they wouldn't do it. For years, I think women who are standing right beside you have been doing a small but important parts in films of biggest heroes and doing it comfortably and doing their place. This is also something that a lot of female actors have brought us, saying that they refuse to do it while women have been doing it for a while. What do you think of this? Because this was an casting issue for you. Your thoughts on this? You work with the biggest of people, and we know that actors who truly don't have egos don't have a problem with this kind of a scenario. So post that, I'd like the women to comment on it.
Actually, ma'am, actually, the scenario is changing now. After the OTT, everything is that scenario has changed, and especially in Tamil, and also my style of working for the last 15 years is I never go beyond a hero for a date or something, anything. For me, first script is the most important thing. First, I'll do the script. Then I'll cast the artist as per what the script demands. Irrelevant of what the market value is, business strategy value, nothing. For me, the artist is with the character, and they have the talent to do the character. That's the two things I just watch. So I always go according to the script. And now, for the last 7-8 years, after the OTT invasion, thing, market boom, everything, lot of female-centric movies can be made. That faith and hope has come to the filmmakers like me, because market value is high. There's no more audience. So maybe there are a couple of heroes we can have count in four or five heroes will be in the market level, irrespective of what the star cast, what the budget, who's the technicians are. They will bring in the crowds. Apart from that, only the content, what the movie is holding, what the movie is giving for the audience, that will bring the audience to the theaters. So there's no the hero or heroine centric, nothing. Now it's common. If you have a nice script to the heroine, the content is good, the movie will be a hit. So that Aramnai 4 has proved that. A lot of female centric movies is coming nowadays. So I don't think now, year after, we have to talk about only hero centric movies will have the market or business value, nothing. Now audience are looking for good content, whether it's hero oriented or heroine oriented. They are not looking for one.
I agree with you, sir. My question, just in continuation, I wanted the ladies of the film who've worked really hard for it to comment also, because this is a thing that I've heard a lot of actors have been trying to do, saying that, you know, we've been doing this for a while, but we don't see that kind of support. Can be disappointing, but we are still going to do what we are doing. So both of your opinions are important, of course.
Can you ask it again? Like, I just want to ask.
Of course. He mentioned that he casted himself in the film, right? Because he said, I knew that this is an important part, but I don't think I would have had, actors with a certain commercial value or market who would be okay to do a film, because they know that the important parts have gone to the two of you. While women in cinema have been doing it for a while, very few actors put their ego aside and they're okay. They don't think about whether it's a female-centric film or not. They are like, the part is interesting, let's do it. He faced that casting issue. My question to you is, you guys also have seen that in the past. You all have been creating your own individual parts and doing it beautifully. What are your opinions on it?
See, thanks Rudrani, thanks for the question.
Of course.
So I actually think of it like, at the end, it is every actor's journey as to what they want to do in cinema, and it is literally an actor's choice. I feel it's unfair to always put everything onto an industry or a gender, because these things are generalizations, but I don't think it works like this. Our industry, although it's a small, close-knit one, every actor has his or her freedom to choose what they want to do, what kind of work they want to do. If somebody with their goodwill wants to do something like this, it's really up to them. So I actually don't hold anything against anybody, because everyone has a different work journey. Yes, I have done many films in which I thought I wanted to be a part of the film, so I did it. But that was me as an actor making that individual choice. Yes, it's lovely if we could get support. But like Sir said, in today's time and age, I don't think it matters. Like, I'm saying it, even for my character, had another girl done this film, I think she would have benefited from this film. This merit would have gone to her. So I feel like what matters today is the content actually being that good, that it pulls people into theatres regardless of who's in it. And I think that's the only way to go forward. I think that's why also we are making waves as a country internationally also. That's because the work is good.
So yeah, that's what I feel about it.
I think they've already answered the question for you. But I'd just like to say that content is king today, and the success of films like Aranmanai is proving that and paving that way forward for all of these individual films where you know women are the lead. And I think it's high time we start making those films, because they are also commercially viable today. So I think we are in a very good time, and a lot of actors, their thinking also I see changing, because now it's not more about arey mera kitna role hai is picture mein, you know, main hoon ke nahi hoon. It's more about, okay, even if it's a small part, how well can I do it, how will this film have a reach because of the content that it has, do I have a good character in it. So their thought processes have changed, and nobody today knows what will work and what will not work. So I think it's the best time to experiment and see what works for you as an actor. And I also feel, I also hope that even male actors start thinking like that. A lot of them that I know have started thinking like that already, because nobody knows, there's no formula anymore. So I feel it's a great time to be actors in the industry, and things are changing. It will still take time, but I hope they change soon. Yeah.
Rashi, your center. Rahul here from the Filmi Charcha. Tamanna, aapse bhi common question hai mera. Marketing strategy har din badalti ja rahi hai film industry ki. Agar Soldier pe based film hai to Soldier ke liye special screening rakhi jati hai. Bachchon pe based film hai to bachchon ke liye rakhi jati hai. Just imagine agar makers ne bhooton ke liye screening rakhi to aap dono ko saath mein baith ke dekhna hai movie. To aap dono ki kya feeling hogi, kya expression honge?
और ऐसा अगर सिचुएशन होती है तो आई थिंक इट्स वेरी एक्साइटिंग फॉर मी, बट आई नो हाउ स्कैर्ड दम नाउ. लेकिन मुझे अंधेरे से भी डर नहीं लगता,
इसीलिए हम टीवी चालू रखते हैं. बहुत ही अच्छा आइडिया है एक्चुअली. हम रखते थे बूथों के लिए स्क्रीनिंग. वैसे भी बूथ सर कटे होते हैं तो उनका सर नहीं होता, तो वो भी आके ये फिल्म अपना दिमाग कहीं छोड़ के ये फिल्म देख सकते हैं. वुड बी ग्रेट, वुड बी लाइक सो मेनी फिल्म्स, राइट?
देन वी गिव अस बेटर आइडियाज टू मेक मोर ऑफ इट.
पॉसिबली मे बी वी विल टेक एन एडवाइस.
या दिस इज
बहुत खुश होंगे, हम बहुत ज्यादा खुश होंगे कि भूतों ने, जो किसी भी फिल्म स्क्रीनिंग को ग्रेस नहीं करते, हमारी फिल्म के लिए आए हैं. ब्यूटीफुल, इम्पोर्टेंट.
Yeah, this is another, you're right, Sohail here from Ancient Point. Yeah, hi. Congratulations to the entire team and wish you all the best. And a very lighter, you know, note, or thoda extending this question also. Kabhi bhooton se paala pada hai kabhi? Matlab bahut baar humne kisse sune hai ki while shooting, you know, the place is haunted or paranormal activities hogi. I would like to know from
ye sawal pehle kisse hai?
Aap teenon se, like jinko experience hua hoga.
Sir, itne itna दहशत फैलाते हैं. आई डोंट थिंक भूत इतना दहशत फैला सकते जितना इंसान फैलाते हैं. तो आई फील हमें भूतों से कम और इंसानों से ज्यादा डरना चाहिए. मुझे भूतों से डर लगता है क्योंकि मैं उनको समझती नहीं हूँ, बट डेफिनेटली मैं डरती ज्यादा इंसानों से.
पर आप जो पूछ रहे थे कि भूतों से पाला पला है,
हाँ, कभी ऐसे होता है ना, एक्सपीरियंस होता है कि कोई जगह हॉन्टेड है?
अच्छा हुआ आपने सवाल उनसे पूछा नहीं. नहीं, मेरे हस्बैंड से नहीं पूछा. तो कहते कि पिछले 30 साल से एक से पाला पड़ा हुआ है. They wanted to know if you have ever experienced anything in this. 30 years.
No, but कोई ऐसी paranormal activities होता है ना, बहुत बार ऐसी जगह होती है जहाँ हमने
काफी होता है. In fact, अगर आप पूछे तो, अगर आप Google भी करें तो the most haunted place जो पूछी सुनी जाती है, apart from Scotland, I think Ooty माना जाता है one of the most haunted places of India. तो हम हर शूटिंग हमारी ऊटी में होती थी, और कहीं ना कोई एक्सपीरियंस होता था हमें. तो मतलब ऐसा है कि कहीं दरवाजे के बाहर कोई आवाज आ रही है, या घर के अंदर सडनली लाइट फ्लिकर हो रही है, तो हम लोग लाइक यार सोने देना, तू भी सो जा. सो दैट इज हाउ वी यूज्ड टू, हमें आदत हो जाती है.
इफ यू गूगल देयर यू विल फाइंड द मोस्ट हॉन्टेड प्लेस इन इंडिया. देयर इज वन स्टूडियो, फेमस स्टूडियो, आई थिंक इट्स योर सेकंड पोजीशन इन दैट मोस्ट haunted place, and most of the industry people have experienced that thing. Somebody, some experience are there. Most of the South stars, you can ask for their experience. most of them will have, some will accept, some won't accept, but most of the top stars won't stay in the particular hotel which is there in the studio.
कभी मुकेश मिल में कभी एक्सपीरियंस किया लॉट्स ऑफ यू हर्ड अबाउट
सोहेल तो पीछे आ रहे हैं
तमन्ना लाइक यू लाइक टू कमेंट एनीथिंग अच्छा ऑन अ लिटिल सीरियस नोट यू नो आईज ऑन राफा लाइक यू नो एवरीवन राइट फ्रॉम द हॉलीवुड टू यू नो द एंटायर फिल्म इंडस्ट्री हैज बीन कमेंटिंग ऑन इट लाइक व्हाट हैव यू टू से लाइक इन एवरीवन
उनके एक्सप्रेशन देख के आधा टाइम मुझे हंसी आ जाती थी और मैं मतलब अपने डायलॉग बोलने से पहले अंदर से एक हंसी को रोकती थी बिकॉज दे आर सो गुड एंड आई वॉज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ लॉट ऑफ दोस कॉमिक सीन्स तो मैंने बहुत एंजॉय किया उनके साथ काम करना ऐसा पर्टिकुलर फनी सीन नहीं है बट आई थिंक द फिल्म ऑन द होल द वे दे हैव रिटन द कॉमेडी इज लेस्ड वेरी वेल तो मुझे बहुत मजा आया उनके साथ काम करके बट आई थिंक बहुत सारे एक्चुअली रोप शॉट्स थे तमन्ना के लिए बहुत ज़्यादा थे मेरे लिए कुछ थे तो वो भी मैंने एक्चुअली एंजॉय किया टू सी ये उड़ते कैसे हैं यू नो बिकॉज पहले कभी मैंने ऐसा एक्सपीरियंस नहीं किया तो वो भी दैट वाज आल्सो फन फॉर मी
ऑनेस्टली
नीतू सिंह फ्रॉम दैनिक भास्कर नीतू सिंह फ्रॉम दैनिक भास्कर मेरा सवाल आपसे है तमन्ना कि सर ने कहा कि आपने काफ़ी सारे एक्शन सीन किए हैं हॉरर फिल्म में बहुत सारे रोप यूज किए गए हैं तो आपकी क्या प्रिपरेशन रही है किस तरह की डिफिकल्टी आई है आपको ये सारे सीन्स करने में क्या एक्सपीरियंस रहा आपका
आई रियली थिंक इस फिल्म के लिए फिजिकल प्रेप से ज़्यादा मेरे लिए इमोशनल प्रेप ज़रूरी था बिकॉज इसके पहले मैंने कभी एक माँ का किरदार वेरी वेरी न्यू फॉर मी लेकिन बहुत ही प्योर इमोशन है इस फिल्म सो फॉर मी कहीं से कूद रही हूँ या कुछ कर रही हूँ आई थिंक नन ऑफ दैट रियली मैटर टू मी बिकॉज जो वजह थी वो हर चीज़ से ज़्यादा ज़रूरी थी सो आई बट आई रियली एन्जॉय बिकॉज ये इस किस्म का डायनामिक शायद एक फिल्म में प्ले करने का मौका नहीं मिलता देयर इज सो मच फिजिकैलिटी इन एक्टिंग बट इट्स ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी इमोशनल तो ये जो ब्लेंड था बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग था मेरे लिए एज एन एक्टर
Excuse me, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
We'll take this last one. And Rashmi, ma'am. The thing is, point is, you guys have played a numerous number of roles so far and completely different from one another. When such film like Arun Manai comes to you and, you know, such roles comes to you, does that make an effect to you that, you know, this is what we want in our craft, this is what we want as an actor to grow as well? Is this kind of role that you guys really want to pick for the craft?
I don't know if I like to speak for Mona because I know she probably feels the same. But I feel as an actor, you want to be able to do all kinds of films. And obviously some will be places where you're not, where it's not very well written. So you do whatever that you get, you make the best out of it and you try to create a character. Some where you know, the whole onus of the film lies on your shoulder, which is great. That's also a film that we would like to do. We also like to do our singing and dancing because I really enjoy that in films. I enjoy commercial films. I enjoy content films. So aisa, I mean, obviously when we are doing a film, we want to see if the script, sometimes the script is great, sometimes the director is great, sometimes the co-star is great. So I think the decision matters on the whole ki hume kya mil raha hai us film se, you know, aur hum har tarah ke kirdar karna chahte hain. To I think a film even like Arun Manai, because I was a part of Arun Manai 3 and I know the way it was made, and I didn't even listen to the script. Honestly, I don't think a lot of people know this, but maine script suni nahi thi, story suni nahi thi. Mujhe sirf Sundar sir ne call kiya aur bola main Arun Manai 4 bana raha hu, I want you in the film. And I said, sir, I'd love to be a part of it. Aur maine script suni thi baith ke unke sath, jab main shot de rahi thi, sir mujhe batana zara ho kya raha hai. And then he said, okay, this is your character, this is what is happening. And it came from this internal belief that I had in him about the film that he will make. As I said, he is the master of that genre and he has proven that with the series. तो कभी कभी आपको वो ट्रस्ट फैक्टर होता है एक फिल्म मेकर में, और ऐसे ही आपकी जर्नी आगे चलती है. अगर आप एक ही तरह की फिल्में करते रहेंगे तो आप भी बोर हो जाएंगे और ऑडियंस भी आपसे बोर हो जाएंगे. So I think for both of us it's important that, you know, our kitty is full of things which are all different from each other.
Hello, hello. Hi, Kushbu ji. Yeah, yeah. This is Chaitanya here. I interviewed you when you started your career.
Oh my God.
Yeah, no, way back. That's okay, you're a fantastic actress, even as a child artist, and even otherwise, you're a fabulous performer. So, was it a conscious decision that you didn't even want to do a cameo role facing the camera in this movie?
अरे क्या बोल रहे हैं आपने नहीं देखा ट्रेलर ठीक से
नहीं ट्रेलर में क्लाइमैक्स सॉन्ग में हूँ मैं वो कैमियो है मेरा
अच्छा ओके
सिर्फ क्लाइमैक्स सॉन्ग में माय सेल्फ एंड सिमरन वी हैव डन अ सॉन्ग बट वो तो मतलब घर की मुर्गी दाल बराबर होती है ना तो आज आप कर लो बट अबाउट जोक्स अपार आई थिंक एज अ प्रोड्यूसर मेरे लिए बहुत जरूरी था कि मेरा नाम वहाँ रहे एज अ प्रोड्यूसर खुशबू सुंदर प्रेजेंस वो ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट था एज एन एक्टर क्योंकि हर वक्त एक फेज होता है कि आप आगे बढ़ते रहते हैं तो लगभग 200 फिल्में कर ली सब नाच गाना सब हो गया कैमरे के सामने सब हो गया कैमरे के पीछे आप किस तरह से अपने आप को संभाल रहे हो बहुत जरूरी हो जाता है
मतलब अगर आपके आप जो कह रहे हैं वो सच हो जाए तो बोलने में मतलब मजा आ जाएगा I should choose wisely. I think I love Shah Rukh. Oh. I just love him. So I would love to do a film with Shah Rukh. Thank you once again, ladies and gentlemen.
I think that they will be able to answer better because he's a distributor.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, madam. See, basically, अगर आप देखो कार्तिके, कांतारा, Legend of Hanuman, ये सब डब होके इधर साउथ की फिल्म में डब होके इधर आई है और जिस तरह से हम लोगों ने वेट किया सक्सेस का इसका रूप देखा उसके बाद हमने डिसाइड किया कि हम 900,000 स्क्रीन्स पे जाएंगे और आप जानते हो कि आईपीएल थे इलेक्शंस थे तो ये माहौल में कलेक्शंस नहीं आते हैं अभी इलेक्शंस भी खत्म हो गए आईपीएल भी खत्म हो गए इसलिए हमने 31st में इसलिए चुना ताकि हम इसको बहुत बड़ा कर सके टैलेंट ने सपोर्ट किया आया प्रमोशन के लिए तो हमको बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ मैं उनके लिए तो उसके वजह से हम एक फिल्म को जिस तरह से मुकाम पे हम लेके जाएंगे और बावेजा स्टूडियोज जिन्होंने हमारे पे विश्वास दिखाया है और उनकी ये उन्होंने फिल्म हमको जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करने का ये जो मौका दिया है और हमारा सपना यही है कि इसको भी हम जिस तरह से तमिल इंडस्ट्री में ये फिल्म बॉक्स ऑफिस किए वही हम इसकी छवि यहाँ पे ऐसे देखना चाहेंगे थैंक यू
वेरी मच गाइस थैंक यू